Over in the country of Georgia, tear gas, water cannons, and stun grenades filled the streets as police tried to break up a second day of protests. The protests began Tuesday against a law seen to critics. The measure, which was approved on first reading, requires any organization receiving more than 20% of their funding from overseas to register as foreign agents or face substantial fines. President Salome Zurabishvili has pledged to veto the bill if it reaches her desk, but Parliament, which is controlled by the ruling Georgian Dream Party, can override her.
The Chinese government is leading threat to U.S. national security and leadership. That's according to U.S. intelligence agencies who claim China is deepening cooperation with Russia in a bid to challenge the world's biggest economy. In their annual global threat assessment, the intelligence agency said Beijing will continue to intimidate rivals in the South China Sea and will probably launch more action on the Taiwan Strait.
Perhaps needless to say, the People's Republic of China, which is increasingly challenging the United States economically, technologically, politically, and militarily around the world, remains our unparalleled priority. Chinese Communist Party, or CCP, under President Xi Jinping, will continue efforts to achieve Xi's vision of making China the preeminent power in East Asia and a major power on the world stage. To fulfill Xi's vision, however, the CCP is increasingly convinced that it can only do so at the expense of U.S. power and influence, and by using coordinated whole-of-government tools to demonstrate strength and compel neighbors to acquiesce to its preferences, including its land, sea, and air claims in the region and its assertions of sovereignty over Taiwan.
The Manila-based regional director of the World Health Organization booted out following accusations of racist and abusive behavior. The move, a first for the WHO, comes after a two-day special meeting of its 34-country executive board in Geneva. According to the WHO, it received allegations of misconduct against Western Pacific Regional Director Takeshi Kasai in the second half of 2021 and in 2022. Kasai has denied those claims. The Japanese doctor, who had worked for the WHO for more than 15 years and had been in the post since 2019. Women across the globe take to the streets to mark the International Women's Day. In France, Parisian women denounced the French government's pension reform plan, which would delay the retirement age by 2 years to 64. Critics say this would disproportionately affect women, who often have less linear careers than men. The French prime minister has said the 64 threshold is non-negotiable, but the government is exploring ways to offset some of the impact, particularly on women. Over in Berlin, thousands called for solidarity with women and the LGBTQ plus community in Iran, who they assert are facing human rights abuses in the country. Some protesters also called for better provision in German daycare centers. And in Istanbul, authorities fired pepper spray to disperse a group holding a Women's Day protest. The clash began when several demonstrators tried to force their way through police barriers. The local government earlier issued a ban on marches, protests, or even press statements to mark the event in the district.
Grim findings from the United Nations Committee on the Elimination of Discrimination Against Women. It found that the Philippines violated the rights of Filipino women who were sexually abused by Japanese soldiers during World War II. The report stemmed from a complaint by Malaya Lolas, a group of sexual slavery survivors, also known as comfort women. They alleged the Philippines did not give reparation, social support, and needed recognition for the Filipino victims. The UN panel called on Manila to provide the full reparation.